One should not try to imitate Lord Shiva. The other one should strictly follow one's prescribed occupational duties. One should never vilify a great personality like Lord Shiva. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta Swami translation purport to the Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto, 4th chapter, 19th verse, spoken in Christabda 5, 2005, 5th month, 30th day, 519th day of Gauranga Mahaprabhu era, 108th year of Prabhupada era. Yeah. So Prabhupada 108 ki?
Yeah. Yeah.
This very heavy part of the Bhagavatam, because sati is exposed to Vaishnava aparad. That's the most painful, despicable poison to be exposed to. It affected her so grievously that she decided to emulate herself in yogic fire and discard the body which was connected to a Vaishnava aparad, namely her father. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advises us to avoid Vaishnava aparad. Vaishnav aparad matal hati upare ba chinde tar sukhi jai pata. The elephant, if the elephant gets let loose in a maddened condition in someone's nice garden, the elephant can create havoc with the garden. Nicely nurtured plants, trees, flowers can be crushed and can be ripped out from the ground by the rampaging elephant. Upare bachin deta suki jai parta. So the example is given that the root of a devotional creeper, the creeper is being pulled out from the ground. Now if you take a plant and pull it out from the ground, to the leaves immediately fall off from the plant, but immediately turn brown. It may take 2 days to completely dry up. But because the root is pulled out from the ground, the nourishment has stopped. So this example is given that in our devotional paper, when we engage, exposed to severe Vaishnava aparat, it's like pulling the creeper out from the root We don't get any more nourishment. And then we systematically start to dry up. We lose the taste for chanting. We lose the taste for deity worship. We lose the taste for reading. We lose the taste for preaching. We lose the taste for book distribution. What could be worse? We lose our devotional service, ultimately. And we just like that dried out, trampled plant which the elephant has pulled out from the root and trampled on, we become a dry crisp, devoid of devotional enthusiasm. Then it's easy to go a chronic offense, going on offending and offending and offending to try to substantiate why I'm not feeling the spiritual happiness and love. They just start to become more and more critical until finally we completely leave devotional service altogether. So this, what could be worse? This is why Sati is saying this is like taking a poison. Better to, when you take poison, the best cure is to vomit it out. Even on some of the liquids in the bathroom, it says that by some reason, somehow you swallow it, vomit it out. When you take a poison, we want to bring it out. So you want to take out all the poison from us. She had her way of doing it. But prevention is also said to be the best cure. We should avoid the Vaishnava Aparad. So it says the better to engage in ourselves in our occupational duty than criticize others. We do a devotional service. We stay engaged always in serving and preaching, and we don't have time to hear the criticisms of others or to speak negatively about others. Sometimes we're put in a situation where our service, like a spiritual master or maybe a temple manager, where we have to oversee people in their spiritual life, we have to find out defects sometimes in order to take remedial action. For that reason, some very great devotees avoided taking disciples. They didn't want to get into that type of fault-finding, infection. Some of the Brajavasi associates of Lord Chaitanya, they just like Narottam Das Thakur to Gopinath Goswami, they took a vow not to take any disciples. Somehow Narottam didn't break his vow. It's an exception. It's not clear why each individual made that decision, but sometimes we hear such reasons, maybe one of the reasons that his souls, they don't want to get into that type of analysis of people's effects and defects. So we try to see the good in others, like what Chaitanya advises, Amaneta Manavina, Kritaniya Sadahari. Offer respect to others, don't expect any respect for oneself. That's another way of avoiding offending. Try to see the good. Even we're advised that we have to give some constructive criticism, we should also see the good in others first. We should appreciate their good qualities and then give their constructive suggestions. It becomes, obviously Daksha is a chronic offender. That's why Shiva didn't even want to go to his function, advice is why you don't go. And she went and immediately she was exposed to offenses against Shiva, who is Vaishnavanam Jata Sambhu, who is the great devotee, greatest devotee, Vaishnava. The 12th canto Bhagavatam says, amongst all Vaishnava, just like Shiva is the greatest, amongst all rivers like Ganga is the greatest, amongst all Shastras, the Bhagavatam is the greatest. So such an exalted Vaishnava is able to drink an ocean of poison and not be affected. Cannot be judged by ordinary calculations. Because Daksha is like, in India they have a kind of Brahman they call smartas. They're very much into the rules and regulations. Any small defect in someone's practice or rules of regulations they want to criticize. Now, of course, things have degraded so much that even the smartest don't follow very strictly, but a few of them are still left that follow. But the criticism may go on amongst those who follow, or try to follow, or think they follow. So it seems that Daksha is that type of Niyamagraha, very much attached to the rules and regulations. So he's finding out some faults with Shiva, failing to see all his good qualities. Prabhupada advised at a certain time in his time, the pujaris had become very critical about the book distributors because they thought, well, the book distributors would sometimes not have as clean a cloth as they come off the street. There would be difference. So there was this kind of condescending attitude from the pujaris to the book distributors because they were not necessarily as suchi. So then Srila Prabhupada took steps to correct that. That everybody is doing the service of Krishna, and that the pujaris are there to decorate the deities because the preachers, they have to go out and they have to be exposed to so many materialistic people. They're doing a great service for the Lord. So when they come back, they can see the beautiful forms of the Lord, and this will be purifying for their minds. But the pujaris shouldn't think that because they're doing deity worship and they will be very clean, that those who are out on the street distributing books are lesser. But rather they also, that's their deity worship, that's their transcendental devotional service. And they're cleaning their heart by distributing transcendental literature. So it's very easy because our egos are always there that we want to think ourselves special. And someone may think that their service is better than another's. And that's what can go to another extreme where they start to criticize the others to make oneself feel more elite or more elevated, special. But then again, we're involving ourselves in this Vaishnava or not. We should do our devotional service, do whatever our prescribed duties are. And not be overly bothered about what other people, what they're doing. If it's our specific service, then okay, maybe we have a service to check on people. Then that's the one exception. But otherwise, why should we be so much
looking for other people's faults. We should look for our own fault. We should see the other devotees as better, try to see their good qualities, see what defects we have and how we can purify ourselves. Sri Prabhupada was so special because he would not stop glorifying Krishna, glorifying the Vaishnavas. He avoided commentaries about other Vaishnavas. Sometimes in extreme circumstances, when we were exposed to some criticism, then for our protection, he had to warn us that these are the dangers, these type of things you shouldn't be exposed to. But he practiced always glorifying Krishna. He wasn't, even he was invited to join the court cases to fight over the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya. But he said, I'd rather build the Mayapur project and do my own preaching than fight over the bricks. Of the birthplace. Lord Chaitanya, we know him as the most merciful. It's Patipavam. But he was very strict when it came to Vaishnava Vrat. When he saw Devananda Pandit, after he had offended Srivas, he publicly chastised him. But you committed a Vaishnava Aparad. You are not having any devotional quality. Your Bhagavatam classes are very dry, speculative. A pure devotee like Srivas comes to your class and you offend him. Publicly chastised. Very hard for Kala Pandits to accept. But the heaviest example that I can think of is Chapal Gopal. You know, Chapal Gopal also he offended. It seemed like Srivas is the most offenseless person. He didn't offend anybody. He just tried to do his devotional service. He was promoting the Sankirtan movement by his providing his garden, the Srivas Angan. In spite of being such an offenseless, such a humble devotee, somehow he attracted offensive people. Maybe sometimes offensive people pick on such humble devotees. So Chapal Gopal, as you know, he painted goat's blood all over the door of Srivas Prabhu and put a tray with a goat's head that was the way they cut the head off for offering to Kali and put the other quote-unquote prasad, Kali prasad, like intestines and other beautiful things there that we don't know on this plate. So then when Srivas opened up his door and found the doors completely painted with blood. Then there's this tray in the front with all these horrible, unmentionable things and the goat's head and everything. And some Java flowers and puja implements of worshipping Devi. It was very disgusting. And some other Brahmins were looking and he said, look at Lord worshipping daily.
Everyone knows he's a pure Vaishnava. He doesn't, he's a pure vegetarian. He doesn't offer goats in there. So, actually, chi, who did this to you? Who made this man? Nobody took it serious. He was not implicated. This became like a bad joke. It didn't take off. So you had to bring the sanitary technicians and they cleaned up the place. And but we know that Chapal Gopal got leprosy after 3 days. For his apparatus. In those days, the lepers were outcast from society. So from an active tantric shakto priest enjoying life in whatever level of society he was in, now he was an outcast, a leper. So he lived inside of the Ganges, out from the city, and his fingers were rotting and decaying. Something, according to Ayurveda, leprosy is a disease of the hairs of the body. The hairs don't go to the extremities, and therefore the circulation doesn't reach there, and therefore the body starts to rot. With a lack of circulation, and gradually the fingers rot and rot and rot, the arm until you're dead. So here he was, after some years, he was already partially decayed. Chapal Gopal saw Lord Chaitanya walking by. And he fell at Lord Chaitanya's feet. My dear Gauranga, Patit Pavan, please, you are the only one who can deliver me. Who else is there in the world who can deliver a fallen soul like me? You are Patit Pavan. Please, please deliver me. I am suffering so much. I want to be your devotee. Normally, Lord Chaitanya will deliver people. But this time, Lord Chaitanya became very stern, very forceful. He said, you have committed a Vaishnav aparad. You are a Vaishnav aparadi. You are going to go to hell. And you are going to be burning there, you're going to be suffering. How can I be saved? What can I do? The only way you can be saved, you must be forgiven by Srivas Thakur. I cannot forgive you because you have offended my devotee. Very unusual to hear such heavy hell and brimstone from Lord Chaitanya, the loving avatar, but because he's also the Lord, he doesn't forgive people for offenses made to Vaishnavas. We have to be forgiven from the Vaishnava. Then the associates who saw this, they said, now Chapal Gopal, change your heart, you'll become a devotee. So they went to see Srivas and said, Srivas, please, you have to forgive Chapal Gopal, then he'll become a devotee. And Srivas said, how can I forgive someone? How can anybody offend me? I am lower than a worm in stool. There's nobody lower than me. How can anybody offend somebody who's lower than me? And like this he was going on and on.
deprecating himself and humbling himself. And these devotees are like scratching their heads to look at Srivas. They weren't giving any money. You don't think you're a devotee. Okay, that's clear. But somehow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thinks you're a devotee. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu won't give his mercy to Chapa Gopal unless you forgive him. If you don't forgive him, he's going to be burning in hell. Do you want him to suffer because of you? No. I don't want anybody to suffer for me. No. I don't want him to suffer. What can I do then? Then you have to go and you have to say that you forgive him. Whatever it is. Whoever you are. Lord, whatever. Lord Chaitanya thinks that you're the Lord, and if you don't do that, he's not going to get the mercy. Okay, then I'll do it. I'll think about it that way.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day. And don't forget to like and share our channel.